Number seven, embrace and enjoy the seasons of life. Perhaps the most famous passage in Ecclesiastes is chapter 3. There's an occasion for everything. There's a time for every activity under heaven. There's a time to give birth and a time to die. There's a time to plant, a time to uproot, a time to search, and a time to count as lost. There's a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time for war and a time for peace. What does the worker gain from his struggles? In context, that means what does the worker gain who is struggling against the changing of those seasons? I have seen the task that God has given the children of Adam to keep them occupied. God has made everything appropriate in its time. God's assignment of life to us includes various seasons. And wisdom means embracing each one appropriately. Foolishness resists the process and tries to hang on to some season because it thinks that happiness is only there and refuses to let that season go. For example, the fool resists aging. God has not designed life in a way where you get to hold on to your youth forever. You got a chapter of it. It's an awesome chapter where your life is characterized by youth and vigor and beauty and strength. And then there's a chapter where your primary contribution that you make can be through your care and wisdom that you show specifically to the rising generation, right? I sometimes mourn the loss of my youth. I will wake up in the morning sore, and all I did the night before was sleep. Somehow going from that angle to that angle is enough to wear me out. I used to be able to eat whatever I wanted. I mean, I would seriously, no joke, drink a full 2-liter bottle of Mountain Dew, full sugar, full caffeine, right before bed, sleep like a baby, and never gain a pound. Now I look at a Fig Newton the wrong way, and I put on a love handle. Unfortunately, I feel like my youthfulness was wasted on me when I was young. I had all this energy and time and didn't know the best way to use it. Now that I got some perspective, I would love to go back, y'all, and live that chapter differently, but I can't. But I can, and now I need to focus on the new chapter that God has given me. In heaven, I'm going to have the wisdom of an old man and the strength and the vigor of a younger one. And that's going to be, but now this is the chapter that I'm in. Many of you can't let go of your youth, you see, because your youth represents for you the only way to happiness. And you got to try to get back there if you're going to be happy again. So you spend hours every week in the gym, spa, and salon, tanning it, tweaking it, tatting it, puffing it, tucking it, lifting it, twisting it, coloring it, rocking it, or whatever you're doing. All the while ignoring the fact that these are going to gain you increasingly diminishing returns, and you're going to die in a few years. And trying to get back to that chapter is a fool's errand. Happiness is embracing the chapter you're in, using it profitably, and being faithful in it. Men tend to do this in their mid-50s. They mourn the loss of their youthfulness, and so they go buy a convertible BMW where Iceman aviators unbutton their shirts down to their navels and hit on college girls and make everybody want to throw up. There are few things in life more pathetic than a man in his 50s who won't let go of the previous chapter of his life and embrace the one that he's in. God has a good purpose for you in this chapter. You can be an incredible blessing to others, and he's got lots of joys for you in that chapter. New kinds of joys. Not the same joys, new kinds. If you'll embrace the present and you'll just let go of the past. There's a time, Solomon says, to embrace retirement and to use your retirement for God's glory and not trying to hang on to your relevance by staying in the game. There's a time for you to let go of your past. Y'all, does it not just amaze you how many self-storage places there are in Raleigh and Durham and Chattanooga? Every single time I see new construction, I'm like, oh, what's going to go there? Oh, it's another self-storage place. For God's sake, let go of your junk. Don't pay somebody $90 a month, right, to hang on to it because you think that, well, the only way that I have connection I have to happiness is all this old junk and I can't let it go because I'll be severing myself from. No, let it go. Just let go of that. There's a time to give it away or throw it away. There's a time to grow up. Many of you college students are going to squander some of the most important years of your life because you don't want to grow up. You want to remain a middle school adolescent with no responsibility, who parties all night and acts like a self-centered moron who was taken care of by mom and dad. There's a time to take responsibility, to quit living in your parents' basement playing video games and become the adult that God wants you to be. There's a time to move out of the house. I read this week that the new adolescent age range in our country is 11 to 30. 11 to 30. Your high school years were great. Let them go. Let them go. There's nothing more pathetic than being in a stage where you won't let go of the previous one. And there's a time, he says, to let go of someone. Some of you have a past romance that you need to let go of. You had this relationship that you thought was going somewhere, but it didn't. And you think now that happiness can only be found back there with that person. Listen, God has a whole life in front of you. Happiness is not back there with the one you lost. It's in the present with what God has for you now. Some of you have lost someone even to death. And I know that life feels like it's going to be miserable without that person, and you need to mourn them. But some of you feel like happiness can only be found back there with them. But see, God has other things for you in life, other people that he needs you to love and bless. And you're going to be reunited with that one you lost in the future. God has a season for that too. But you can't be a help to the people in your present if you remain captive to the past. There is a time, he says, to let go. His point, God has ordained seasons for you. You've got to embrace and you've got to enjoy each one and not just be captive to the future and not be captive to the past. Some of the best parenting advice I have ever heard was this: enjoy every season of your child's life and don't get caught looking ahead to the next one or clinging to the previous one. Just enjoy the one that's in front of you because it's going to pass by and you can't go back to it. Embrace the seasons that change and just enjoy them.